everyone. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. Last week's performance for this guy was nothing to write home about, but he can take comfort in the fact that they did walk away with the win. He'll be hoping to play a much bigger role in the...
Here's Brad Wing now to punt it away on fourth down. He gets this away. It's a good one. Drawing toward the sidelines. And this will be out of bounds, and they spot it at the 15-yard line. Not too bad.
Here we go.
First down, Kaiser. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. That goes for a gain of 31.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball down.
Offense looking to avoid a third and long. It's second and 10.
Here we go.
Now Kaiser. Open receiver. That's David Njoku. And they'll get him down here at the 23. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
They gave up the completion there, but this is what zone defenses count on. Catching the ball and not much run after the catch.
He's got a man. It's Mitchell. And brought down, but the juke, the very nice juke, gets him the first down yardage there. That'll move the sticks for the Browns, a gain of 12. On first and 10, Kaiser. And his throw is incomplete. They were trying to get it there to Josh Doctson, and that'll bring up second down. Kaiser yet again, and his throw's going to be incomplete. And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. Again, it's Kaiser. And that's incomplete. Brad Wing now on for his second punt. He'd take a repeat of his first. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. And taken right on the 30. A very good return there. Give him an even 20 yards. And this offense takes over in great shape right at the 50. First and 10. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. Kaiser now from the 50. Throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete. The intended target was Corey Coleman. And now it's second down.
One thing I have learned, receivers don't mind high throws so much to the sideline, but do that over the middle to them, and not only are the DBs going to throw their verbal trash their way, when they get back to the huddle, they have a few words to say to their QB, aren't they?
Yeah, hung out to dry a little bit there on the high throw. Luckily, fell incomplete. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down. So here we go, a third down after the second down pass completion. Working out of the gun. Here's Kaiser. Left side, that's caught by Mitchell. Well, he's taken down, but not before picking up the first thanks to a flashy little spin move. That'll move the sticks for the Browns, a gain of 12.
Would it be safe to say that as precise as routes are supposed to be run in the NFL, maybe they're not quite as precise in college ball?
That's accurate, yeah.
And I think we saw a college route in the NFL there. Just find the soft spot, find the dead zone, and find the first down. And that's what he just did.
And this time the yards won't come so easy as they'll, in fact, tackle him behind the line. He lost four there, and it's third down.
Jason Pierre-Paul first burst on the scene for me, headed towards his draft year. You know what I saw him doing? like 15, 16 backflips in a row on a YouTube video.
Athlete.
Absolute athlete. And he uses that agility to slip past guys and make plays in the backfield.
That draft year 2010, 15th overall pick.
How about that run? Picks up a first down. Make the enthusiasm in my voice. Remember, last week, AFC Offensive Player of the Week. I think he's trying to get another one in the fold.
And you talked, watching film, a lot about his form and just hitting the hole, running north and south, as we like to say. And I think he's been doing that a lot recently.
Squaring those shoulders and getting downhill.
Back with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gaudin. Second down, Kaiser. That's complete, right around the 8. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. 9 yards on the play there, and it sets him up first and goal.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it.
And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Cleveland. A great play there. So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. This is fielded at the goal line. And a good return. He's across the 35-yard line, right around the 36. And now Cleveland geared up to take the field. And that last drive was very, very balanced, pretty methodical. You think they go that route again?
I'm always of the school that until they stop me from doing something, I'm going to continue. And I think that that's exactly what they'll look to do. But the beauty is the balance that they've created sets up opportunities for big plays. Looks like a run, turn into a play action, and throw one deep.
Now a handoff looking right. That'll move the sticks for the Browns, a gain of 12.
Absolutely love the run right there. This guy's known for his quickness, but also for his speed, and he's able to get to the second level almost before you blink if you give him any type of blocking. Always talk about slot receivers, and they're usually known as quicker than fast. In this case, we've got a guy who's quick and fast, and he used it to great advantage. He had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. And he'll get it inside the 40 to the 39. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. The Browns on third down. They've been good, 3 for 4 thus far. They're up against a 3rd-and-1 situation. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he's going to be taken down right at the line. They'll be marked inches short. No gain on the play. And that's going to lead him to fourth down. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38. It'll be a pickup of only a yard. And they're able to convert here on 4th-and-inches.
Let's go!
Kaiser on first down. And he can't get away from the pressure. The Giants get there. Devon Kennard in there to take him down and to take us to the 2-minute warning. 2 minutes to play in a tightly contested first half. More from Cleveland after this. And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. So he loses 3 yards there. Now third down.
Well, forget about finding a lane there. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. Probably fortunate he's able to hold on to the football.
They'll throw here. Kaiser. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. A gain of 26 on the third down conversion. So a big pickup that time. And Charles, defending AFC Player of the Week, maybe bucking towards another award this week.
Yeah, and they say they don't really care about the individual awards. You and I both know.
They do.
It means a lot to them. It means respect around the league. And if he's able to show those kind of hands all game long, he can win a second one. But one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown him a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after him, they've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept him on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now gives him a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
And that is incomplete. Here's Brad Wing now as he's on to punt for New York. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. Pulled in at the 24. Sheds off the tackle. And all the way in. Touchdown, Cleveland. A great effort there. 76. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. This will be taken in at the one. Shifts by him. And he's got Rome. Does the big boy have the juice? And he'll score. Touchdown, Browns. A great play there. 99 yards. Here's Brad Wing now. He's been one of their few bright spots so far. Averaging over 50 yards a punt so far as this one's away. Fair catch called for and made right at the 25-yard line. They'll call that a 33-yard punt with no return. And the Browns will take over first and 10. Heading out is the Cleveland offense now as they get set to take over here. This is sort of what you would call a put-away drive, isn't it? I mean, they score here, especially a touchdown. It's almost out of reach.
It certainly feels that way, and I think that they're going to call their plays accordingly because what you really want to do, even though you know the scoreboard is still up there and the game's going to go on, in fact, you can take the spirit away from another team. Their drive and will to come back and win can be taken with another score right here.
Still third quarter, but you just get that feel.
Yeah, the teeters right there on the brink, aren't they?
And it gives us time to the tailback. And a nice spin into some open field. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. That's good for a Cleveland first down, an 11-yard pickup.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball and protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. Now they try the right side here. And now running right through it. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a first down again.
Boy, he does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. Straight ahead, peripheral. Also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think that helps set him up.
And he'll take it into the end zone for a Browns touchdown. A great effort there. An 18-yard touchdown run. And the Browns add on to their lead. Here's Brad Wing now as he's on for the fifth time here today. He gets this away as he'll wisely, I'd say, angle this to the sideline. This is taken at about the 14. It'll be 37 yards there on the punt, and the offense will take over with a new set of downs. Getting set to go again as we look at the back heading onto the field again. He has been a touchdown machine. It has been enjoyable to watch.
And the scoreboard continues to light up as a result of his efforts. He's been a blast, though. Every time you look up, you just figure, if he's got the ball in his hands, he's going to end up in the end zone. It's been that kind of a game for
Absolutely.
Him.
Now you just keep waiting for more. They'll run it now out of the gun. And some room to maneuver. And down he'll go at the 25. It's a 7-yard gain there, and it's good enough to move the chains. And third quarter here, you've got the lead. This is where that strong run game can really benefit you. Stayed in bounds there, kept the clock going.
I like all the points you just made there. And if you throw the football and it's incomplete, now you've stopped the clock and you've helped out the guys on the other side of the ball. So keep it in the hands of those runners. Keep moving and keep grinding clock. You know how we get focused at end of the half and end of the game situations about how much time's on the board and about what you need to do? Sometimes you don't even have to worry about that. That's just smart football. You know, that kind of a lead, staying in bounds, it burns clock, even in a situation that we're not really focused on it.
Now a handoff looking right. Oh, and now he bowls him over. So he got free of one tackle, but couldn't do a whole lot else. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again, go play action, hit him over the top.
And he'll get across midfield and down to the 48-yard line. Give him 3 on the run there. Now they're looking at a 3rd and about 5.
They're in a pretty good spot right now with a convincing lead. I think this is where they put on the boxing gloves to start to try and pound them into submission.
And the offensive line, they've controlled this game. I don't see why that trend would change now. It's a pickup of 3, but it brings up what will be an interesting 4th and 1. And he'll give it here to his running back. Spins past it. The big man, get the oxygen tank ready. And all the way in. Touchdown, Cleveland. A big play there. 45 yards. So still lots of work left to do, but here comes the onside kick. There he goes. Now they're down big here in the 4th. They had to try the onside kick. Can't fault him for the effort at least.
No, you can't at all. And if nothing else, now you've put something that you're trying to practice, right, that you've worked on into a game situation, and now you can go back and dissect it. So if you need it again sometime, maybe you'll find a better way to do it. But, yeah, this game's pretty much done for them.
A good play there as the Browns strike for 16 and a first down. And looking to put this game on ice in the 4th quarter, but still not afraid to throw it, as they show there.
You want to play the game with confidence, and they have a guy who's in control right now. Their trigger guy throwing it, they feel just as confident with him doing that as they would if they tried to run the ball and run the clock out.
It's a good gain of 11, sets him up 1st and goal.
Do my eyes deceive me, or is he getting stronger as this game moves along?
Burst seems just as good here in the 4th as it was way back in the 1st, doesn't it?
I do believe someone put a lot of time in the offseason and continues to condition during the season in order to continue to carry the ball at this rate. Brandon, it's clearly a running situation when you're up in the 4th quarter. They're going to have to stack the box and make it difficult for them to move the ball.
Made it very difficult right there. Now they need to repeat that effort.
Yeah, bring 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take.
And he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This is fielded at the goal line. And now Cleveland geared up to take the field. They have the big lead here late. They protected their home turf well, didn't they?
They certainly did, partner. And just think about how good that feels, because every team has a goal when they start the year to win at home. All right, and sometimes you don't win all of them, but they managed to get that done today. Just think about your routine stays the same. Everything's familiar. You feel right going into the game, and they translated that into a win.
They did indeed. They protected the home field, and now the final stages. And they will stop him after a fairly minimal pickup. Call it about a gain of 3, and they'll be looking at a 3rd and 7 coming up.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. And when he can make the play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
And he's got the 1st down, yardage before being taken down at midfield. That's good for 21 yards and a 1st down. And a new set of downs here after picking up the 1st on the ground. And they're throwing here. Kizer over the middle, the catch by Coleman. Some extra space following the display of power down just inside the 45.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call,